WinMill Software presents Advanced Reporting, Adding Custom Attributes to Reports with Jaspersoft. In CA PPM version 14.2, CA introduced a new reporting tool called Jaspersoft. In this demo, we will demonstrate how to build custom attributes and have them included in ad hoc reports using Jaspersoft. The goal of this demonstration is to add a custom attribute to the project object. For this example, we will add the attribute of go live date to the project. We will then add this custom attribute to the data warehouse and build an ad hoc view to display the new custom attribute. Prior to CA PPM version 14.2, with business objects, adding custom attributes required creating custom universes. These universes either had to be linked to the out-of-the-box CA PPM universes or be all-encompassing, which means it contained all stock objects as well as custom objects. Doing so required a resource with both CA PPM data schema and business objects designer knowledge. With Jaspersoft, this can all be accomplished through the CA PPM UI. There is no need for Jaspersoft developers or DBAs. Custom attributes and custom objects can be made available for reporting by simply running a job. Now we will demonstrate how to add these attributes and create our report. First, we will navigate to our object. And we are going to add our attribute to the project object. Select attributes. We'll select new. And here we'll create our attribute for go live date. We'll make this a date. We will give it a default of 1/1/2000. And we're going to populate null values with the default. This way, all the projects in the system will have a value. And you'll notice there's a new checkbox that says include in data warehouse. We will check that box so that it gets added into the Jaspersoft data warehouse and select save and return. At this point, our attribute has been created, but it is not yet included in the data warehouse. The next step is to navigate to Reports and Jobs, the Jobs tab, and we will run a job called Load Data Warehouse. Every time a new attribute is added and you would like it to be included in the data warehouse, you must run this job. When the job is complete, we'll now navigate to Advanced Reporting to create our view. So we go to Create Ad Hoc View. Navigate to Domains. And we will select the Project Management domain and select Choose Data. For this example, we're simply going to display the project name, project ID, and if we expand the custom folder, we will see our custom attribute. Here we have go live date, and we'll display this as a table. We will add attributes and we can see our January 1, 2000 date has been populated and we'll save our ad hoc view. So we have seen that we can now add custom fields to our objects and have them included in our advanced reporting without the need for additional developers or DBAs. Thank you for watching the demo. If you have any questions, please contact WinMill Software.